Yes, this crime, violence, cruelty, greed, meanness, selfishness, indifference, apathy to human suffering. If someone has fallen on the side of the road, nobody wants to take care of it. This is human apathy. There is no humanity at all. And such is the value crisis in all aspects of our life, political, economic and social. Pursuit of material value is the only sabse bada rupaya. See, per dollar, paisa, wealth, power. This is the only value that is what is considered. And that's the reason why there is the exploitation all over the world. Only bhoga and bhoga and enjoyment on material level, on physical level. And this has become the only purpose. So the values of another very important value such as idealism, altruism, selfishness, service to fellow men are becoming increasingly rare. The in society we are the ideal persons are becoming rare and rare and rare. And so children want to imitate someone, and the ideal persons are becoming rare, and children have nothing to imitate. But they want happiness, and they are searching happiness in a wrong way. That is in alcoholism, in gambling, and in chorus and afim and whatnot. Because they are not finding, they want joy. Everyone wants joy. But then one has to search at a right place. They are not getting in society great stimulating personalities, and that's the reason why in campus, students in campus, there is violence and so on. There is drug addiction in and so on. The other day in Pune, the survey was made, which college is the best college? And the result, this survey was, is one can see, and the best college is that college which conducts very few classes. This is the, where there are so many canteens. Okay, so this is the criteria of good education. There is a deterioration. See, we have the habit of blaming our forefathers that they were ignorant. They were not able to sign their signature. They used to put thumb. So much uneducated they were. But look how educated we are, highly educated we are. We also sign other signature. This is what we call the sign of education. And that's the reason why there is a deterioration. And sensitivity to, in today's society, in even the student society, there is no sensitivity to beauty, art, and nature, and so on and so forth. And the same problem, if we see from the different angle, the nation which has what you call commitment, ideological commitment, just as for example, India has an ideological commitment towards democracy, okay, and also socialism, and also secularism and so on. These are the ideals, secularism, socialism or democracy, and these ideals are now in very much severe danger. There is, what is happening is that between our tradition and the scientific new development, there is a wide gap. Because of the scientific education, our traditional wisdom, between present day education and our traditional wisdom, there is a great gap. And this gap has to be, is reflected in the generation gap. There is a wide gap between the new generation and the old generation. And this gap has to be overcome. Actually, there is a deculturalization, dehumanization, and that is the alienation, and this has to be overcome. And hence, we want value education. And this value education, that too through yoga. Value education program is carried on through any good educational method is the method of value education. But we are students of yoga, and we want to utilize the precepts and practices of yoga for realizing the value educational methods, for storytelling and through drama and video and audio programs. Value education is very well carried on in every university and in every college. But then, can we do the same carrying of value education through yoga? That is our concern, and if we are successful in that, we will be widening the applicability of yoga. And yoga, we can say that yoga is useful not only for therapy, but also for educational therapy. Entire education, entire society has become sick, and through yogic precepts and practices, can we overcome these problems? That is the question, and this is not a very easy question. Everything cannot be achieved within no time. Yoga is not a machine or jadu or trick. If you put man from one end, from another end, he will be or she will be Superman. No. One has to have lot of papad willing, lot of trouble taking is there. But then, our concern is that yogic education emphasizing the values will help us educating the person in a more and more better way. So there are so many other reasons need of value education, but then the important thing is that page number 11, I think, I summarize this saying that there are a number of reasons for value education. Okay, the physical environment also, we are tapping physical environment for our enjoyment purposes. Deforestation, we are practicing Vrakshasan, tree pose, and we are taking the contract of cutting the trees. This is the situation nowadays. Contradiction in our life. So, preservation of the environment is very much necessary. And this message, the exploitation of the earthly, minerals and so on, all this has to be stopped. And this is symbolized by Vrikshasan and Parvatasan, mount pose and tree pose. What's the use of performing tree pose and mountain pose if we are not sensitive to the environment? Yes, if we are not sensitive to environment. So these performance of asanas build us the sensitivity, and that's the reason why value education. To summarize the need of value education is that we must be very careful in celebrating some one day or seminar or what you call 1 week seminar is of no use. We have to bring a drastic change in our outlook, in our philosophy, in our habits. And this is the demand of the day, and this demand we want to fulfill through yogic education. But for that purpose, yogic education must be reoriented. It must, while teaching yoga, the values inbuilt in the aspects of yoga need to be highlighted and emphasized. And see, in the crisis of the society, now we are passing through crisis of the society. Corona is its result. We have not cared for the society, or we have not cared for the nature. Okay. But then, simple, superfluous changes will not do at all. In the times of the crisis of the society, it is the only education that should emerge to set right the situation. This is the purpose of education, to identify the ill-begotten, the bad values, or disvalues, and replace in their places the correct values. So, to establish the order in the society, that is one of the purposes of education. And if this is not the purpose of education, only military and police will be the agency which we should be invited for doing this work. And that's the reason why if education of every nation has to put up, has to set right the order in the society, and in this setting order in the society, education has a great role, and in that education, yoga will also has a great role, and hence the value education. Now, this further, I would like to. Now, very interesting thing is that why I have brought yoga for value education purposes is that now, by being worried about the crisis in the society, the great educationists, great scientists and psychologists, and great persons of thought and thinking, they have come together. They are coming together, or they have come together, and they have thought on the problem how to overcome this crisis. And they have suggested some values. They have given some suggestions, some recommendations. See, in India and in every nation, every 5 or 6 years, educationists come together and think about the education situation, and then it reviews the education situation, and it suggests certain recommendations are given. Similarly, is the case with Indian education also. Every 5 year, Indian Education Commission has given the recommendations for what? For overcoming the crisis in the society. Okay. For better education of the children. And it's very heartening and very interesting to know that the suggestions and recommendations given by education society are values. In terms of values, Education Commission has given some recommendations. And further, very important thing is that those values are nothing but basic values, and they are identical with yamas and niyamas. That's the view, and this makes me to connect the realization of value educational objectives through yoga, because yoga also has inbuilt in it those basic values: non-violence, tolerance, and love, and righteousness, and so on and so. These are the basic values which, see, we are here. We have a long list of recommendations of those values. It has gone. We have a long list of recommendation of values. Recommended by whom? Recommended by educationists of the world. I have also references from World Health Organization or UNO, and also the Japanese government. They have also given a very good list. Okay, I have at present I have not included in that, but then what I want to say is that in order to overcome the value crisis, the remedy is given, And that remedy is given in terms of values. And those values are identical with the values that are in yoga. That is Yama Niyamas. This is the logic. This is the what. And see, the some reasons are there. And the recommendations and proposals. For example, I will also show you how these recommendations are some form or the other of Yamas and Niyamas. Okay. Now, to develop human resource, to promote self-development, to become aware of one's powers, need of man-making education. Okay. Need of man-making education, character building. Now, can't we achieve these objectives through yogic education? And this is this I want to show through this seminar. Need of rising above the caste and differences, synthesizing materialism and spirituality. How to synthesize materialism and spirituality through yogically? Simple. See, this Trikonasana. Our one hand is touching the earth or towards the earth, and our another hand is pointing towards sky. Sky is a symbol of spirituality. Through Trikonasana, we are synthesizing, we are uniting the materiality and spirituality. I mean, we are not teaching in this way. So, synthesizing the materialism and spiritualism, and to promote philosophy of live and let live is nothing but form of ahimsa, non-violence. And also to develop scientific temper and independent spirit of mind and soul. So this, see, we have in science, there is the scientific attitude. In yoga, we have yogic attitude. Unless scientific attitude is developed, we cannot understand science. Similarly, in yoga, there is yogic attitude, drishti, gaze, and that is attitude. And that attitude is free of kleshas. Kleshas are dogmatics, subjective things, but we have to rise above the kleshas. We have to rise above the kleshas, and in this way, objective attitude has to be developed. Yoga is not against developing objective attitude. So, need of developing scientific attitude, and see the 20th. Next one. Yes. See the 20th. To enable the conscious internalization of healthy work ethos. Now, what we are doing, what we are seeing is, this is the remedy aspect. In order to overcome the crisis, we have to undertake this program. And one of the thing is that, develop scientific temper and also enable the conscious internalization of work ethos, healthy work ethos. See, the development of scientific temper is matter of knowledge, Jnana Yoga. Okay, and development of healthy work ethos is matter of Karma Yoga. See, what I want to show you with logic, I am not asking you to believe me. You see with your own eyes and how best yoga is for realizing the objectives of value education. Value education demands development of proper attitude, independent thinking, independent judgment, taking decision. This is what value education is not giving some ready-made values, ready-made package for door to door. No. What values I must realize. I must decide by myself. How? On the basis of my aim. My values must be in consonance with my aim. If I want to become a doctor, the values necessary for becoming doctor will be my values. If I want to become a yogi, all the conducive yogic values I must realize. So, healthy work habit. Today, what Education Commission is recommending is that among children, there must be scientific attitude development. No dogmatism, no what you call religious blind faith and so on. Objectivity must be there, scientific attitude must be there. So also, as regard the work, healthy work ethos, we are going to speak in detail what this healthy work ethos is in our coming PPTs. But then, healthy work ethos is one of the requirements. See, the logic is that, again and again I am repeating, there is crisis and mankind is suffering from that crisis. And in order to remove that crisis, Education Commission have recommended certain remedies, and those remedies are values, and those values are inbuilt in yoga. That is the logic. And hence, value education through yoga. So this 20th number, after that, it has helped, it has also suggested 21st. I'm not touching all, but just in brief. See, the subject is very vast, and I must make what you call balanced presentation of the subject, because yoga is a balance. Yoga samatu uchyate. Just now we are going to see that. But then, nurture values like love and compassion. What ahimsa? In among the yamas, there is ahimsa. And what is this ahimsa? Love and compassion. If it is not love and compassion. So, I am not saying that these recommendations, those Education Commissions have studied yoga and from yoga they have given. No, they have given these recommendations independently. And fortunately, those recommendations are nothing but, in other words, the yogic wisdom, you accept it or not, you have to realize it, that yogic wisdom, it in this way is universal. It is the yoga is a remedy. Yoga is a remedy, and in this way, the human values. See, 24th point is, I will sum up this small topic of the remedies, and those remedies are yogic. Why yogic? Because those values are in yoga also. And hence, yoga is the best method of value education. Mulya yoga. Yoging with mulya. Uniting with mulya. Internalizing the mulya. Mulya means values. The 24th, I just summarize it. See, the values recommended are basic values. Basic five values. And those basic values, five values are identical with yamas, and they are truth, righteousness, peace, love, and non-violence. And these are the universal values.